All right, good morning, Ibadan. It's still a fantastic morning here in the city. And while the sun is out after the rain, I told you I was going to be at OJ Market, and that's where I am currently. I'm speaking to you from OJ Market. Well, we're not out on the street yet. We're in the car because I wanted to talk to you very quickly about to the chef I told you about. Well, call her a chef. I'll ask her how she would prefer to be described, actually. But I mean, someone who cooks, someone who makes soups. Her name is Peju Aegbayo, but a lot of people know her business as Zuriel Spot. Hi, Peju. How are you? Good morning.
Hi, good morning.
Good to have you here.
Good to be back.
Now, I mean, you told me that you rarely shop at OJ Market. Why do you avoid OJ Market?
First, because it's rowdy.
I know, right?
But usually I prefer Bodija or Scout Camp Challenge.
Okay.
And it depends, basically. It depends on what I have to cook.
Okay.
If I have to cook a lot of Igbo dishes,
yes,
that I need a lot of native ingredients, I cook it. I buy from Bodija.
Okay.
But if it's normal everyday stuff, then I buy from Scouts Camp Challenge. I only come to OJ once in a while. Once in a while.
I absolutely love OJ. I mean, just driving it. Did you see how at all of the, as
the
in the color.
Sandal, yes.
The color is absolutely beautiful. Greens, reds. I mean,
like, a lot of them are just coming in from the farms. You
absolutely
can tell, because they have a lot of fresh produce and all.
Okay, so we're here to definitely discover why. Obviously, we know that prices of everything has gone up. But a lot, specifically about tomatoes. I'm sure you've heard about that, Pedro. Tell us.
Oh, yes. there are a lot of speculations on the reason why tomatoes are expensive, but because we don't have facts, we can't actually say this is why.
Yes.
Some people say there was a disease on tomatoes. Some people say Dangote is buying off all the tomatoes because he's about to start off a tomato puree business as well. But basically, we don't really have to use tomatoes in our stews. There's a trend now with tomatoless stews, and the ripple effect of this is, after I share the recipe, if a lot of people adopt this practice, you know, the demand on tomatoes will reduce, and hopefully maybe they'll cut down the prices. Hopefully.
I know. Did you ever envisage? I mean, we just always used to think that, I mean, what's pepper without tomatoes? It's just like they're like 5 and 6. But then we have to face the realization that we can actually do without tomatoes. Now, before we go on to talk to the market women about the tomatoes and some of the commodities that are expensive, we're just going to talk to us about, I mean, obviously, is the scarcity that, or has it always been tomatoless soups, or is the scarcity that forced people to sort of invent the tomatoless soup? And then what is tomatoless soup?
Actually, I don't think there has always been tomatoless soup, but this is a way of, how do I say it, like a cushioning effect,
yes,
a way to live in these times, a way to not just drill a hole in your pocket, so to speak, because tomatoes are really expensive. I mean, you won't eat stews anymore because tomatoes, not you eat stews, and then you still get the same nourishment, you still get the same health benefits, only that you're not using tomatoes. You cannot just, because there's so the demand on tomatoes is so high, you know, let's try and cut that down and see if they'll just reduce the prices, hopefully. So the tomatoless stew is something that people came up with.
Yes.
Funny enough, one of the recipes I have was given to me by one of these market women.
Really?
Yeah, because she said to me, she said, anything around tomato anymore, you know.
And you're thinking, okay,
and I said, killing you one low. And then she told me, this is what she does. And I'm like, wow. I went home, I tried it, and it worked.
Wow.
You know, so I just thought, okay, this is really good. So you need to be open-minded. These women,
yes,
really know what they're doing.
I know. Okay, so before Peju tells us about how to make this tomatoless soup, we're going to go and talk to the market women, especially the people who sell tomatoes. We're going to find out exactly how much the tomatoes cost right now. I'll also find out a few things for you. So stay tuned. We're going to take a commercial break right now. Peju's going to be back after we talk to the market women. Peju and I will go walk a few miles down the road and a few steps, maybe, and then ask why tomatoes are expensive from the market women's angle. I'm sure you want to know, but stay tuned because soon Pedro will tell you how to cook that tomatoless soup. All right, so it's still the morning splash. We're here at OJ Market. That's right, OJ Market, where everything looks luscious this beautiful morning in the city of Ibadan. I'm so excited to be outdoors and excited to be here. My name is Ronke Giwa. Stay tuned, because when we come back, we're speaking to the market women, and of course, Pedro will talk to us about the tomatoless soup. All right, over to you, Karadi. Thank you. Please play some commercials. We'll be right back. All right, we're still live here at OJ Market. This is the morning slash extraordinaire.
Mama,
show you know where our tomato is.
Nigeria already now.
Okay, well, you can hear the whole market is lamenting right now. I mean, I've never seen people this disgruntled. We're talking to the Mama Loja. Well, it's just a woman around the that's selling the tomatoes and the pepper. I'm going to just talk to her for a few more minutes. Mama Era Mao. Mama. All right, you can hear the woman said that things are very costly. That obviously this is something that's come from the north, and so they're having to settle to buy the Yoruba tomatoes. I didn't even know, Pedro, that there was Yoruba tomatoes.
Yeah, there is. That's Yoruba tomatoes, the little ones. Yeah, they're like baby tomatoes. Those are Yoruba tomatoes. The plump and fresh ones, those ones are very attractive. Those are the Hausa tomatoes and are quite expensive. I'm sure that would be nothing less than 500.
You can ask. I can count now. The 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Five tomatoes for 500 naira. 200 for 3 tomatoes. Okay, this one, there's 4. 4 tomatoes, 300 naira. How much would you have bought that? Let's say what, like 3 months ago?
The 200 naira one would have gone for 100. Because this is OJ, sometimes you can even get it as low as 50 naira. Yes. And then the one at the back should be nothing less than, more than 150.
Yes, I mean, I know when I want to get a real good bargain, I definitely come to OJ.
So OJ
if
like
they are lamenting and they are, I mean, doubling the price of everything, I can imagine like the likes of Bodija Market.
Yes, it is. Yes, it is. Bodija will probably be like double of what this is.
Yes.
And then most times, for instance, in Scouts Camp where I shop, most of these peppers are still fresh. The ones that they sell for 200 in Scout Camp, most of them are a bit rotten already. The 500 naira upwards are the ones that are still plump and fresh. From 200 are the rotten ones. But this is still fair enough.
I mean, Keju, one of the consequences I thought about also is the fact that, I mean, bookers and maybe some of those restaurants will start to cut corners and sell and cook rotting tomatoes and rotting...
Of course, yes. So they can break even. I mean, we're all in Nigeria and we understand the economy. So I wouldn't exactly say I blame them for cutting corners, because they really need to break even. So most of them will just come and buy off all of these rotten ones on the floor, which is why, like the mama said, there's an alternative. Shombo is a very good supplement.
Yes.
It makes your stew very red and it makes it thick. So why not use shombo? Take advantage of the cheap things, cheap items. Onions are very, very cheap at the moment. So just take advantage of onions, satsashe, red bell peppers and shombo and make your stew. And trust me, it will come out very nice. You will not even miss tomatoes.
Okay, remember I told you that Kwesi is going to tell us how to make that tomato-less soup. She's already given you a few pointers and a few hints, but I'm not going to let her let the cat out of the bag yet, because we're still here on the morning splash. I'm actually trying to time check, but time is past. It's about 20 minutes before 11. Okay, all right, so 20 minutes before 11, we're right here in the middle of OJ Market, where it feels like everybody's complaining. Nobody's happy.
Nobody at all. People have even shifted from tomatoes to gari and and Elubo, and everybody's complaining. A woman's slip has just cut, and she said it's a gym of That is hilarious. I mean, it's a ripple effect from tomatoes to every other item. Rice that used to be like 350 per Congo is now 500, 600 in some places. Gari as well, Elubo as well. So it's a ripple effect. It will affect every other thing in the market, even down to fruits. Fruits are now expensive. Yes, you could get a whole ball of watermelon, I mean a good size, for 200 here in Oje. I doubt that you'd ever see that now.
Wow. Okay, we're gonna test that out. I see some really big fat watermelons over there. I love watermelons, I love fruits, so I mean the fact that my darling fruits are now about double the price, now that would affect me, because I'm not much of a foodie, but I'm a fruity. You can call me a fruity. I love fruits. Okay, still the morning splash right smack in the middle of OJ Market here in the city of Ibadan. That's where the second half of the morning splash is holding, and so we're going to take you right back to the studio to take some more commercials. Just check out our fan page on Facebook. You see pictures of me here in OJ. If you think that maybe this one is
fake, oh, it's real. I mean, the noise and all. Exactly. Someone advertises something across the road. This is proper OJ.
So check out our social media page. You see pictures of me right here in the city of Ibadan in OJ Market, where we're looking at why tomatoes are expensive. No one seems to know. That's
yeah, like I said, there's a lot of speculations, and because we don't have facts, we can't exactly say this is the reason or this is why. I mean, it happens at this time, you know, for tomatoes to be a bit expensive, but not, this is like outrageous. This is really unbearable for a lot of people.
Yes, I mean, before I've heard, oh, pepper is expensive, but I've never, tomatoes have never been, you know,
been this hard. It's like gold right now.
Okay. All right, so we're going to take some more commercials. And then when I come back, I will be talking to Peju, and she'll be talking to us about how to cook the tomatoless soup. Like I said, she already gave you hints on using shombo as a substitute, but find out how exactly to make it work without tomatoes. Did you ever envisage a life without tomatoes? Well, hey, reality check, everyone. Tomatoes are expensive, and we've got to make sure we adapt. That's my.
Because a lot of Nigerian food is based on stew. We need to complement with stew or soup. So we need an alternative.
Hey, my name is Ronke Giwa, reporting live from OJ Market. We'll take some commercials. It's the morning splash. We'll be right back. Don't go away. All right. Okay. Imagine that I actually got carried away. That's what happens to you when you're in OJ Market. I mean, everything just looks so lush and so wonderful. In spite of, I mean, the angst that people feel, the frustration with the hiking, almost everything. Well, what can we do? I had to buy some watermelons and some pineapples. I just couldn't resist it. And Kuju is the ultimate, well, we're calling it negotiator. It's the ultimate
they
bargain.
She told you now, how can you buy that for 500?
I know those watermelons were as fat as two of my heads. Yes. And Peju was able to get it for how much did you get it?
350.
350 naira. Wow. Awesome. Well done, Peju.
Thank you. Well, initially, you know, I didn't used to be that good with negotiation, but after coming to the market over and over, you know, okay. You just develop the skills somehow.
Ah, okay. All right, so we have to go soon, but before we let Peju go, first of all, you can follow her on Instagram at Zuriel Sport. Zuriel Sport is spelled
ZURIELESPOT.
Okay, that's ZU. Double R.
No, no.
Oh, Z U one R.
Yes, one
I-E
R.
L
L L
L L E
E S P O T.
All right. Okay, and then obviously we'll give you a number to call her as well. I mean, she's been so gracious coming here and coming to OJ Market with you. I don't know if I would have survived without her. So thanks. Even though I've been here,
You're welcome.
Here a lot. All right. So the tomatoes.
Okay. Yes. I hope you have your pens and your papers and whatever you can scribble on. It's very, very easy. There are two types. The first one. A market woman actually gave me the recipe. If you can tolerate tomato purees, just buy a sachet of tomato purees, shombo, and tatashe. Blend this all up. Before frying the pepper, you want to, flavor your oil with a knob of fresh ginger.
Ginger, ooh.
Fry that for about 5 minutes. Once it starts to bubble, take out the ginger and pour the pepper in. Cook as you cook your normal stew, and trust me, you will not even miss tomatoes.
Wow.
That's for people that can tolerate tomato purees.
Yes.
Now, if you can't tolerate it, the other one is to use tatashe, shombo. It must be fresh shombo and a lot of onions. Now, for those people who want a little bit of pepper in their stew, add just like 3 pieces of rodo, that's the scotch bonnet.
Right.
But if you don't like pepper, just take, you can discard the rodo, yes, then de-seed the pepper.
Take out the seeds
from the shombo and the tatashe.
Yes.
Blend it with enough onions. For instance, you're using two cups of shombo, 2 cups of tatashe.
Yes.
You need 2 big bulbs of onions. Mm-hmm. Blend that all. The onions in it will so aromatize, if there's any such word,
yes,
your stew. You will not even believe it. Make that and fry it like you're going to fry the first recipe I gave, with a knob of ginger, and eat that with rice, with a wedu, with anything. Mm-hmm. It is absolutely delicious.
Wow.
And you get all the nutrients, because red bell peppers have times 10 the vitamin C that you have in oranges.
Oh,
the same
wow.
with shombo.
Yes.
You know, so you're not missing anything, just the tomatoes. And hopefully, if people adopt this method of making their stews without tomatoes, the prices, the demand of tomatoes will fall, and hopefully the price will crash. So
awesome.
Very easy, easy peasy. I'll make it and then put up a demonstration on my page, and then you can
see. On Instagram.
Yes, on Instagram, Twitter, and Facebook.
At Zuriel's Spot.
Yes.
At Zuriel's Spot. Spell Zuriel's once again.
Z-U. RIELLESPOT.
All right, on Instagram and Twitter.
On Instagram, Twitter, and Facebook, yes.
Wow.
You'll see the demonstration, live demonstration. If you don't mind, you can also come and taste.
Yes, how can people reach you? What's your number?
08079642550.
Okay. Okay. All right, well, Nigeria, can you believe that you can actually cook without tomatoes? Now we've learned, and the circumstances in town has forced us to be innovative, and I'm glad that Nigerians can be innovative in times like this. Thank you all so much for listening to my adventure here at OJ. I'm sweating and I look like one of the market women, but that's good because they are all absolutely beautiful. Thank you once again, Peju, Ayegbayo.
Yes,
for coming. That's it on the Morning Splash. A big thank you to Tokwe Fade, for Toby Kushimo, and all the team that have come here to OJ Market with me to make sure this live broadcast has been possible. I'll be back on the Morning Splash tomorrow from 7 a.m. My name is Ronke Giwa. Have an absolutely fantastic Monday. God bless.